Welcome to a quick video tutorial on using recursion in Desmos. Recursive sequences occur when the value of each term depends on one or more other terms, often those that came just before. Here, we see a table with a sequence of terms. The first term is 5, the second term is 8, and so on. Given that the first 5 terms of our sequence are 5, 8, 11, 14, and 17, how would you describe this sequence? You may notice that each term is 3 more than the previous term. Using function notation, we can begin defining this as a function, f of n, where n represents which term we are evaluating for. We represent the previous term as f of n minus 1. Now, because we want to increase that previous term by 3 every time, we will include a plus 3. Notice how the add base case button shows up as soon as we refer to another term in our function by typing f of n minus 1, which identifies this as a recursive function. We need to add the first term in our sequence as a starting point to work forward from. By clicking to add a base case of f of 1, the default starting value is 1. Looking at our table, we want the first term to be 5, so we will set f of 1 equals 5. Now that our base case is set, our function describing the sequence in our table is fully defined. Let's try calculating the future terms in the sequence using function notation. By typing f of 10, we see the 10th term is 32, and typing f of 100 shows us the 100th term is 302. To help us visualize this function, and to quickly see if it matches the values we started with, we can create a table from our function. By pressing the Create Table icon that appears to the left of our expression, we see a table that is automatically populated with the first 5 terms. We can hit Enter from the bottom row to see the next term, or calculate any future term by entering a term number in the first column. Learn more about recursion and other features in the Desmos Help Center. We can't wait to see what you create.